have to support and to guide them. Of course, at the very beginning, they might feel, okay, so hard to solve the problem. But if they have faith, okay, this is a test from God, okay, and use the proper treatment, one day, inshallah, they can go back to the right track.
I just want to make a comment on this one. I just want to emphasize a few points in this regard to this. First, Islam doesn't deal with margins. It sets a framework for the whole. If we look at the number of people who have this tendency of whether male or female, you see the percentage of those people in the general population of the world, how much are they? How many? It's at the margin. Maybe you heard about Spider-Man. There's one French guy who specialized in climbing the tallest building in the world. And he will jump. From the tallest place, he will jump on the floor. He's not dying. He kept on doing it. Because he's doing it, will anyone of us here go and do the same thing? That is a margin. It's not the general rule for everyone. It's, you have maybe somebody, Clément Ader, is a French guy who had 63 accidents in an airplane, 63 crashes. He's still living. He's died on his bed. Is that normal or is a margin? So Islam does not deal with these, it does set the framework for the general, for the whole guidance. If you see this ayah, it's chapter 16, verse 72. I invite you to go and investigate this ayah and then study it in depth, not just reading this meaning here, the translation. I give you a few more. Another one is chapter 4, verse number 1. Where God Almighty is talking to all mankind. He said he has created us from a single soul. And from that soul he created his mate. And from those two he created countless men and women. From those two, he's saying two, meaning from a male and a female. Can you imagine now if the majority of the people in the world were to adopt this tendency of homosexuality, male going to male and women going with women, what will happen in a few years? What will happen? There won't be any regeneration of human society. It will collapse. So this tendency of being homosexual or lesbian is not because we are fanatics, Muslims, that we are rejecting it, but it's against the natural course of everything. We don't fight with homosexuals, actually. We try to guide them. We try to protect them and show them this is not the correct way. In the United States, USA, which is considered as the most civilized, advanced country, homosexuality was seen until very, very recently as a disease. They have many different clinics in different states where they are treating people and trying to guide them back to go to the natural path, that a man will go for a woman and a woman will go for a man. And in Islam, it doesn't just say a man will just go for a woman. Me, I cannot go for any woman. I have to go with the one to whom I'm married to. It's not open to all. Because I'm a heterosexual, so it's open license for me to grab anyone. Just women is okay. No, it's not okay. It's a woman with me, but to whom I'm married. Islam also has this tendency of homosexuality in the young age. It has a remedy for that. The Prophet said in an authentic narration that when your children reaches the age of 10, separate them in the bed. You don't put them together. Whether they are boys together or different keep them in the same bed. And if before that, even if they, before they reach the age of 10, they should not use the same bed cover, what is it called? Bed sheet. You have to separate. They have to have a different cover for each one of them. They don't share the same. So this is to prevent them having corrupted mind at a young age. So in Islam, there is no encouragement at all for these kind of things. And if someone happened to be in this position, we don't say he's doomed. We have to reject him, you don't come with us, don't enter. No, we try to educate them and treat them. There is a treatment for this one. We believe he's a disease. In South Africa, until around 2000, the year 2000, they were considering homosexuality officially as a disease. They are helping the people to get proper treatment in order to get this out of their mind. This is the reason Islam does not encourage celibacy. I, as a man, I cannot remain single forever, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created me for purpose. I should worship him. I should also generate. I should marry and give birth to generate, you know, to help the society to grow.
It is also part of the bad.
It is part of the deen. The sister told you, if you marry, the Prophet said, if you marry, you complete half of your deen. And then the brother ironically asked, he is joking. He said, if you marry then for the second time, does it mean you fully complete your deen? No. It means if I'm married, it guards me from doing immoral things. Naturally, whether he's a man or a woman, we have this tendency, we have this need for intimacy. And the chapter the sister gave me before is chapter 30 of the Quran, Surah Rum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, he has placed love and mercy between the spouses, men and women. Study this very well.
I didn't make a comment from a religious point of view. I was just saying that.
No, I'm not addressing you, sister. I'm just making a general comment. And
that's why she said that there are several
things. When you are with your spouse, you're having a difficult time. You stay together for a long time. In the beginning, it's love. Affection is there. You care in each other and all these things. And then later on, difficulties start to come up in the relationship. No more honey every morning. Oh, how are you doing, honey? You know, when she's going into the car, you don't open the door anymore. You don't close it. It's just up to you. When she's carrying something, you don't help. The love is eroding, but the mercy will remain. So when you remain with this person, later on you consider them as somebody within yourself. You feel pain when they have pain. So this is the kind of description Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave in that chapter, love and mercy. So in Islam, homosexuality cannot be accepted for many reasons Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given, and the one some of them I have given you just now.
I think sometimes it's also hard when we have family members, okay, they also practice maybe homosexuality. Okay, whether accept or not accept is difficult for us. But when we come back to religion, we say that actually one of the signs for the day of judgment to come is more and more people practice homosexuality. So it means it is something bad. Where something actually most of the signs